Hello guys, and welcome back to the Speedplay base, and welcome to my new machine room, or my power room. The full size boiler is running on one single tree. That's self-sufficient in all ways, I think. Oh, it's dark. Let's go out and check how it looks outside. It's actually so efficient, so I'm getting much more charcoal and saplings that I can use up. So I will need to... I don't want to blow this up. I will need to find a way to shut things down. For example, if these are filled up, I need to shut it down. And also, I think... Yeah, it does shut down today, but I have no way of turning it back on. So I think if this one is full, then it will just emergency shut down. But when things are getting empty, it won't turn back on again. So yeah, perhaps a good subject for a future video. Let's see, we have 16 and a half stacks. Let's see how much we get after this. Still filling up. 16 and a half, and now we are... Okay, so we got two stacks and then another tree, like, instantly. Okay, so I need to fix that. It's too good. Just too good. And down here I had some issues with the world, so I had to use a backup. Be careful with thermal dynamics, because my test world was ruined when I used the thermal dynamics what are they called? Conduit? Liquid conduit or something? I don't know. It was, if you place it in the world will crash. At least mine did when I placed it on the fluid port. So be careful and, yeah, I don't know why. Be careful and to do regular backups. So here I think I used the design from one of my videos of Big Reactors. I have the link in the video description for this specific one I'm talking about. And I tried to use that design, but it wasn't really valid in this mod pack for some reason. I did this in a test world and I had to reduce it or change it a little, and it's quite good anyway. And this hasn't we haven't settled yet. It might be because we're not at full temperature yet. Anyway, this is outputting a lot more than the 160 I had before with the small boiler, and now with a new tree, full size low pressure boiler, perhaps I'm able to make a high pressure boiler. I haven't tried it. I will think about it. In anyway, right now I don't need it, because this design should produce something like close to 4000 RF per tick. A little less, I think. And right now I can't output, because this energy conduit that you can't craft anymore, because you have to use industrial craft cables, I can only receive 400 RF per tick, and I think the conduit states that... No, 640. Anyway, it's not enough. So I will need to bump this up and probably use an energy cell. Let's see. Send receive 8000. And this is 800. So I will need to go for redstone energy cell for this. And that means another type of cable. perhaps not possible to use the power monitor anymore, but we'll get the numbers here anyway. So lots of stuff happening in coming videos around in this room. Very fun. I really like it. It's quite overpowered, but it's a nice build, and I like it a lot. And the room looks, well, a little better at least. So that's it, I think. I didn't do anything else. I made a lot of this stuff off cam with the patterns and things. And you have seen that before. And right now I'm just running up and down manually. I need to avoid stuff, but not today. Take care, guys, and I see you in the next video. Bye-bye.